Hey guys, welcome to the channel. If you are new here, this is only the second video I have made so far, so it should be pretty easy if you want to catch up. I managed to make pretty rapid progress on the Iron Cross over these last few months, and I wanted to share the training methods and mental cues that helped me accomplish this. As a disclaimer, I am not able to perfectly hold the move, let alone for several seconds, but I went ahead and made this video now rather than once I am further along so that you guys can go ahead and hear my tips and advice earlier on. First of all, I want to establish that the Iron Cross is not as difficult as it is generally made out to be. It is hard, but it is not the pinnacle of bodyweight strength or something like that. Both Maltese, Full Planche, and a handful of other moves are substantially more difficult, at least in my opinion. This is all just to say that you can accomplish the move easier than you may think. Now, we need to address the scapula positioning for the move since it is sort of the basis of the hold. You can either try to roll your shoulders forward or just keep them back as much as possible. I would recommend not trying to do either and instead just doing what feels natural and what feels best and what allows you to be the strongest in the position. Also, there are two main wrist positions for the move: the normal grip, which makes the progressions and exercise much more difficult and much more taxing on the biceps, and the false grip, which makes the exercise easier and also puts your shoulders in a more natural position, at least in my experience. I would definitely do most of your progression with the false grip for learning Iron Cross, and maybe an occasional set with the straight grip just for variety. You can also work on a straight grip later on in your calisthenics journey. This brings me to a crucial point, which is this. The first 1 to 2 weeks of your Iron Cross training, and I'd say 2 weeks is better, they should really be dedicated only to easy holds in which you are learning to feel the Iron Cross position. This is when you fully allow your motor system to learn the position, and from here, it is only a downhill battle since now you just have to improve your strength in the position that you've already learned. If you saw the video on learning the planche, you know my view that high consistency, low volume, and high intensity is the best mix for rapid progress in calisthenics, and naturally, that same philosophy applies here as well. The following exercises you need to be practicing every day, a small amount of sets per day, and except for the first 2 weeks, you want them to be in high intensity and short holds, and also with great form. Frequent training helps you learn the move so much faster than you would otherwise. Here are the exercises I would use to train for the Iron Cross. The first one is the leg-supported Iron Cross, which is what you will spend your first couple of weeks on in order to learn the position. It is really easy to scale this progression up or down by manipulating the height of your feet relative to your waist. I always did this progression in really short 3 to 5 second holds because that hold time really ingrains the pattern into your mind and doesn't create muscle soreness or burnout. This should be the main exercise in your progression towards Iron Cross. You can also do feet-supported Iron Cross raises, but I didn't do these very much because 1, I found it kind of awkward, 2, I was trying to learn the hold itself, not really the raise, and then 3, a couple of exercises that I am going to include in this video cover that range of motion anyways. Doing raises in this progression is certainly an option, but I just spend more of my time on the actual position itself. Now, let's cover the ring-assisted progressions. This is the first variety, which you perform as such. Since the feet-supported Iron Cross progression holds such a good simulation of the hold itself, I generally use this exercise for raises. Keep in mind that this exercise basically supplants the role of the biceps and instead engages basically only your chest. So you can still use this progression, but I would definitely use it as a supplement in conjunction with better simulations such as the box-supported Iron Cross progression. A more difficult version is putting the strap around your wrist as such, which is much harder than the first version. Once again, this move still mainly trains your chest and doesn't develop the biceps and elbow tendons and joints, so I would still not use it very much. Third is the Iron Cross fly. How far you descend into the move before pressing back up just depends on your strength level. This exercise is also a chest dominant one, so you can use it some to work on that component of the Iron Cross, but it should still be used as a supplement to the box cross. Banded Iron Cross progressions are also pretty popular. I would not recommend doing them all that much unless you have a band that makes it so you can actually do a full Iron Cross assisted hold. You want to have a band that helps you enough. Unlike the last two exercises, this one, since it is just a simulation of the final progression after all, trains your biceps quite well. There are also several options for placing the band around your body. The first is under your shoulders. You can either do it across your chest or across your back. The first option is generally preferable because the last one kind of messes with your scapula position. Alternatively, you can use the band this way, which is mainly good for L-sit Iron Crosses or L-sit Iron Cross raises, or instead you can put it under your knees, and that's going to be the easiest version because it stretches the band the most. A helpful supplement is feet-assisted Maltese to planche presses, which really build up your biceps and elbow strength. You make the move harder by putting the rings lower and leaning further forward into the move. You guys really liked the suggested routine I made for the planche video, so here is one for the iron cross. In my opinion, and just based on my experience and the advice I've given in the past, this is the best way to train for the iron cross. Thank you guys for watching the video. I really hope you found it helpful. Just let me know in the comments if there's anything I can do better, or what you liked, what you didn't like about the video production style, and I'll definitely take your feedback into account in future videos. Thank you very much, and best of luck in your calisthenics journey.